Vamos tell your neighbor, vamos say neighbor. Neighbor. Hey, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
God is able. For this reason, for this cause, I also suffer these things. Nevertheless, I am not ashamed. For I know whom I have believed, and am persuaded that he is able to keep what I have committed to him until that day. I'm almost done with the message, because I strongly believe Paul writes a letter in what I call the midst of strain, stress, suffering, pain, being beat down, being abused, being misused. Paul writes a letter that's common to every last one of us in here today. It's common because the longer that we will live, the more trouble shall rise. As a matter of fact, persecution, problems, trials, and tribulation really is an everyday experience. And since it is an everyday experience, I just want to remind you today that God is able. But in order for us to really get there, I thought about what is it, what's the message that Paul really wanted us to see today. He writes to his young protege, Timothy. And he's writing to him as a pastor, as a friend, as a brother, as a confidant. He's writing to him as an encourager, to let him know that although life will throw some curveballs at you, although life gives you some things that you won't expect, but what you need to pull from it is to know that the Lord is able.
Yes,
I thought about it today, Pilgrim, on my way to heaven. I thought about, why did not Paul crack up? I wondered why Paul, out of all of his experiences, guys, why he didn't lose his mind. I wondered why physically, mentally, and especially spiritually, he was able to keep going. I put myself the best way I could in the shoes of the Apostle Paul, but I really couldn't. Because I don't know all the time if I'm strong enough. I try to be. But am I strong enough to say that in whatever state I find myself in, I'll be content? Am I really strong enough to say, really, that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me? Am I really strong enough, really, to say that I gotta know that all things will work together for good to them that love God? I love him. But can I really definitively say that I know that all things are, can I really stand up and say, you know what, for me to live is Christ and to die, come on, is gain. Can I really, I'm thinking about me, I don't know. Can I really say that, you know what, I'm going to keep on pressing. No matter how hard it gets, I'm going to push my way through. Because I'm pressing for the mark, for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Can I really say like the Apostle Paul, I'm going to give thanks in everything that I do, because it is the will of God. I gotta rejoice all the time. I gotta give thanks every day. I gotta be thankful and praise and honor the Lord in everything that happens to me, whether it's good or whether it's bad. Well, I'm not Paul, but I am saved. So I stand on something today that all of us who are saved in here should stand on. And that is the reality that faith will turn any situation around. Trusting God throughout a storm will allow that storm to cease. Trusting God in any and every situation will put us in a place of knowing today that the Lord will never leave us, nor will he forsake us. Because it is the Apostle Paul, my brothers and sisters, who actually says, now unto him, put all this stuff together, but he said, now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we will ask or think, according to the power that worketh within us. So I came back to the text and I thought about Paul and I said, well, Paul writes to Timothy, as I give this message to you today, as an encourager, as a pastor, as one who is your friend and your brother, to remind you of something. Through every fear, through every time of frustration, through every misunderstanding, through every trial, through every tribulation, whatever it is, loss of friends, loss of loved ones, I want you to know what Paul is actually saying. Because what Paul is actually saying, he says, first of all, realize that being a Christian, you will suffer. But in your suffering, that is something that will bring you through. And that is knowing today without a doubt that the Lord, he will prevail. I heard the old church say it like this, and I said all the time, he may not always come when you want him to come. But he's always what? Right on time. Because Paul is really helping us to understand the sense and the power of faith. What happens when we really trust God? Through it, in it. If we trust him through it and in it, it turns it around. And when we trust him in it and through it and it turns it around, then guess what? It won't look the same as that we went. When we went into it, it won't look the same when we come out of it. Because if God will bring us in it, God is still the same one who'll take us through it. Okay. So I thought about it. Because this is what Paul writes to Timothy on his way out. When his ministry, his work was coming to an end, and he's reminding them of something. He said, listen, he says, for this cause, this reason, I also will suffer these things, okay? But he said, nevertheless, whatever's happening, whatever goes on around me, I will not be ashamed. For I know in whom, this is it, y'all. I know in whom I have believed. And I am persuaded that he is able to keep what I have committed unto him until this day. Paul was the one who said, I'm suffering at such a level that he says, I have a thorn in my flesh. He says, what's going on with me? He says, this Satan is buffeting me. He's beating me. He's putting me through it. But he said, I learned something. Because when the Lord spoke in his buffering experience, in his thorn experience, in whatever he was going through, the Lord spoke to him and says, hold on that. Because my grace, it is sufficient. That's why I give him all my glory. I give him all the thanks. I give him all the praise. Because he is Alpha. And he is Omega. This is what I call, out of many things that I've read about, the Apostle Paul, this is what I actually call one of his defining moments. I'm suffering, you will suffer. But he says, through it all, I'm not going to give up. What he's actually saying, he says, when I think about where I am, first thing that I must understand is that I must understand my salvation. And since he said, I must understand my salvation, he comes back and he says, all that I'm going through, I will not be ashamed. He was the one who wrote to the church at Rome. And what did he say in chapter 1? He says, with all that is within me, I am ready to preach the gospel. He says, for I am not ashamed of the gospel. Why? It is the power of God unto salvation. To whom? To everyone. What's your defining moment? I'm waiting. What's your defining moment? What's your testimony?
Yes.
What has the Lord really done for you? Because if he's done anything, he woke you up. If he's done anything, he brought you out. He keeps Moses at a defining moment. His defining moment was the moment with the burning bush. Peter had a defining moment when he met Jesus, when he saw Jesus walking on water, and he had the experience of walking on water. It was another defining moment. Matter of fact, it was Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had a defining moment when they made it through a fiery furnace. It was another defining moment that Daniel had, because Daniel had a defining moment in the lion's den. Joshua had a defining moment when he was able to depart the Jordan River and walk into the promised land after Moses' leadership for 40 years, that he walked the children of Israel into the promised land. That was his defining moment. But Paul even had a defining moment, and his defining moment was a moment that Paul had when he met Jesus. He met Jesus on the Damascus Road in a blinding experience, but not only was it a blinding experience, but it was an experience when he heard the voice of God. I don't know what your defining moment is today, but I think all of us need to have one. I don't know if it's like a Moses, a Peter, a Shadrach, a Daniel. I don't know if it's like a Joshua or a Paul, but it be your own defining moment when you can say, without a doubt today, I met Jesus. You can say without a doubt that the Lord has brought you through. Without a doubt today that God has carried you to the next level of trust and belief in your life. I just said it's because of faith. Faith is still the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Listen today. The reason, and I'm out the way, the reason that we can stand so strong on the power of this text today is because of three things. The first thing that I find about the power of this text, I said God is able. The text even said God is able. Said he is able. What is he able to do? How do I know he's able? Paul said, I know that he's able because of the strength that he gave me during my suffering. Say it again, Rev. The strength that I gave during my suffering. See, if you've never been through nothing, you don't know what the Lord can do.
Yes.
But you've been through something. What is important about this text is that Paul recognized something that's in the previous verse. In the previous verse, look at it. Verse 11. He says, I was appointed a preacher and apostle and a teacher. He understood his calling, guys. He understood what the Lord had called him to do. And I have told you the last several years of my pastorate, I've told you that you must work according to what? Your spiritual
gift.
Gift. Why? It will bring not only peace into your life, but it will balance out your life. When you do what you are doing, not for self-gain, the Lord has called you to do. Come on. And so he's